This curator is equipped for menagerie management.
Welcome to Chef Sasha, season 2, episode 2. This is gonna be the first episode of all cooking, and I got my homie Dave in the house.
Yeah.
So Dave, you're gonna hook us up with one of your specialties. This is like one of your panty dropper situations.
Absolute panty dropper dinner course. This is gonna be solid.
Okay, great. So we're gonna do some chicken thighs. We're gonna pound them. We're gonna roll them. We're gonna cut them, fry them, bake them, something along those lines.
Yeah. And then we're going to start with a beautiful, beautiful starter that I had in Florence at this restaurant called...
Do you remember the name? That's amazing. If you remember the name, I'm going to be blown away. Okay.
You've been feeding me dark and stormies.
So I'll be blown away later by the name of the restaurant. All right. So
Buca Mario.
I'm blown away now.
There we go.
Buca Mario.
Buca Mario. Mario. Florence.
Mario's mouth.
Into the Florence.
Yeah. Mario's mouth. Yeah. That's a tough restaurant to open in New York. Mario's mouth. Ooh. All right, on that note, so what's the first step to getting the chicken started?
All right, we're going to nerd out a little bit. We're going to do a little bit of deboning chicken thighs, which I think you guys have done once or twice on this show.
We did. We had a chef.
Not to bore the viewers, but I think this is kind of a game changer, whether you're doing barbecue or you're doing anything. A, because they're cheaper, they're tastier, and
there's some chicken legs in there
really,
too.
Really, really simple.
Why don't you give me the chicken legs in here and I'll save those for
Let's
later.
See what we got going on in here. We got a mixed batch.
We got a mixed bag.
Oh, we got some drums.
I'll take the drums.
Boom, 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 boom.
Actually, right, why don't we put the drums back in the bag?
Done deal.
All right, put the drums back in the bag, back in the back of the bag. Okay. So, right in there.
Garbage.
All right, so...
So this is super easy. Super, super easy.
Oh, you know what I forgot? I forgot my apron.
Where's my drink? Is this how this show goes?
Yeah, exactly. This is how... All right, good. Dave, do you want an apron or are you okay?
No, I'm good.
Okay.
I got a thing over here.
You got a thing.
All right, so what are we looking at? All right, so basically... Do an X down the middle.
Oh, this is slightly different than the last deboning that we. Oh.
And then you shave.
So this is much easier, that's for sure. Then you shave it. Okay.
And then you go in hard.
The pinch and
pinch
the pull.
Under. And the one side will pull out. And the other side you have to cut.
Okay. But you're losing a little meat over here. I'm not gonna lie to you.
A little bit of action. Yeah. But if you're dealing with like a 10-pack of bones and you're doing a barbecue,
yeah,
and you do this game,
you're just gonna finish it really
fast.
And
you pound it and you pound it out and then marinate it, and then sear it real quick on a barbecue. It's a knockout.
Money in the bank.
And it's super easy.
Okay. So how did you learn how to do this technique?
Just reading about it. I actually went. One of my best friends went to a university in Oxford, Mississippi.
Uh-huh.
And I went to go stay with him a long, long time ago. And I went to a house party where someone pulled up with a propane tank on wheels, which turned out to be the smoker.
Oh.
And I became a little bit obsessed with...
Bones, please.
Barbecue.
Thank you.
Sasha, tell the people what you're doing in that bag.
Oh, so the bag is full of bones and chicken necks and chicken backs and chicken wings and winglets, and I save it in the freezer for when I need to make chicken stock. So that's an episode we haven't done, as we haven't done the chicken stock episode, because that's like a long... You know what we should do, Tom? We should do a ladder grind 4-hour chicken stock episode.
That's a great idea.
Where we get a couple of people over here to just grind the ladder. Maybe we do Sasha the Legend. Last 2 days of the month,
six hours,
yeah. rotating cast of unemployed Hearthstone enthusiasts. All right, so what are you doing? Taking the skin off?
So I'm taking the skin off because we're going to make like a really gross, really bad for you treat while we're cooking.
So my mom makes something similar to this. It's All a right. Jewish treat called grievous.
Grievous.
And what you do is when you know when you're like breaking down a chicken, a whole chicken, and there's like the chicken butt and there's like big chunks of fat kind of peppered throughout the chicken?
Yep.
She takes those and just pan fries them with a little salt and that's it.
Done deal.
And she just eats it with a fork while nobody's looking.
Well, we're going to make these into chicken fritters.
Little nice.
Chicken crisps.
You want a little like tiny thing? Here, yeah, have a tiny
you can
thing.
Do that. Save that on the side.
On the side.
All right, so now we're just going to pound these suckers out.
All right. Okay, so you're going to pound them out. I've never really pounded chicken. You put them all in at once or one at a time?
No, just one at a time.
Okay, and then here's a pounding implement.
Thank you, sir.
Let's move the knife. There you go. So are you going for... What's the thickness you're going for?
Thin as possible. Just because it...
Like a quarter inch?
Yeah, quarter inch. A bit fancy. Just because it slows down it makes the cooking time a little faster.
What do you want, a plate?
Just a plate.
Here, how's a plate?
Plate's beautiful, thank you, sir.
Okay, excellent. All right, so more chicken pounding.
More chicken pounding.
I'm gonna try the last one because this looks half fun, half gratifying.
Yeah, get in there.
Get weird. I've got no chicken hands. Why don't you chickenify that in there?
All right, done.
Oh, but now I've got chicken hands because you chicken handed this. So. But now we're
chicken hands.
Chicken hand
you.
Brothers.
Chicken hands all over it.
Oh, clearly I'm not a pro. I have no idea what I'm doing.
No, you're good.
That's good?
Smash it.
I don't know. Is that good?
Done.
Done? Okay.
All right. Now these guys are we're gonna leave over here.
Okay.
Just for a little bit, and we're gonna make some sauce.
Okay. So I'm gonna move. Are we done with this? Or are you gonna still do some chopping?
Yeah, leave that there.
Okay. So you can do like a quick tomato sauce.
Okay, quick tomato sauce for the base.
We gotta get a can opener. That's for damn sure. Okay. So we got a can opener.
And this is super, super simple.
Pardon the reach.
Sorry.
All right, so half. So you got an onion trick? Whoa, slow down, slow down.
I know. It's
so the people want to know. The people are gonna want to know.
sorry, bros.
So
Tomek just told me to cool out.
So what are you about to do with your onion? Because everybody's got a little technique, a little trick. I learned mine one way. There's the French way. There's the fancy way. There's the not so fancy way. So what are you about to break out?
This is the poor man's pantry way. This is just quickest and easiest. Basically, you cut the end that's not where the root ball is. Take that off.
One different one for each?
No, I screwed up.
Oh, okay. This is not the root ball.
You guys are making me nervous.
All right, yeah, that's okay. You'll relax after you finish your first darkened dog.
Yeah.
You have a dog? That's what I've heard.
I do, apparently. Apparently this episode's called Dark and Stormy. That's why we're drinking Dark and Stormies.
The episode's called Chicken and Portals.
Oh, Chicken and Portals.
Chicken and Prosciutto Portals.
I thought it was Tofu Nuggets.
I could see the confusion between the chicken and the dog and the portals and the nuggets and the tofu. So...
It's a cute dog.
It's a cute dog?
It's a sort of otherworldly dog, to be honest.
It is
like
an otherworldly dog.
Has come from a portal?
Yeah, it's like a ball of colors and...
He has one eye on the heavens and one eye on hell.
Yeah, two different color eyes.
Really?
So in terms of this onion thing, I totally screwed that up, but... We're gonna roll with it.
Yeah, use that good half.
Okay.
No, I'm gonna do both of them. Just chop the top off.
Your knife is much sharper than mine. That's for sure.
Oh, let's talk about that, Dave. Dave brought his own knife. Dave, you want to talk about that a little bit?
Nah, it's just an old knife.
So
this old thing.
So what's your sharpening world? Because I just got into sharpening my knife, and I'm not very good at it.
I do have one at home, and I traditionally do that before I use the knife at all, but it's just old school.
You don't have a whetstone?
No. Do you have a whetstone?
I have one because I was told to get one because I got berated for having a dull knife last time.
I thought this wasn't that fancy a joint. My God.
I don't have a honing.
Pizza's watching. We should congratulate him on his...
Pizza! Congratulations, brother. So a good friend of ours.
Pizza!
Exactly. A friend of ours just got signed to a Hearthstone team, so he is playing professionally, playing video games professionally.
Amazing!
Isn't that pretty cool?
You gonna make some money, brother?
You know he's gonna make that money.
Probably is gonna make some money. We're gonna have him on in 2 weeks.
Maybe we'll give him a couple bucks just so like we can start. He can get the ball rolling. All right, you need a little bowl?
Yeah, no, I'm good. If we could get some heat happening.
You want heat?
But wait,
little
I'm sorry.
Heat,
I
little olive oil.
I missed the thing. So you sharpen your knives or you don't sharpen your knives?
No, I do the thing with the thing. Right. That's about it.
It's good?
You're good,
If we have time, I'm sure Sasha could show you the whetstone.
It's a tiny whetstone. I bought the wrong one off Amazon because yada, yada, yada.
Overruled. You're fancy.
Like the Senate and Congress.
Yeah.
So this tomato sauce is super, super simple.
Okay.
Onion, garlic, lemon zest, a little lemon. Lemons on them. And we're out. And that's it.
Okay, so lemon, garlic. We're going to send you home with clean dishes as much as we can. Because I have a zester here.
Pizza says
I've got the
14-year-old in him finally made it.
I'll tell you, the 14-year-old in me is still doing whatever 14-year-olds do and not making money. All right, how much zest do you need? I guess I should
give this a rinse. We're not there yet. We're not there yet.
We're not there yet?
We're good. So tell me, guys, talk to me about the show.
So we've been going on a year and a full year, and now this is episode 2 of year 2.
Yeah.
And it started off, the first year was all Hearthstone, all video games, plus cooking. You know, a lot of showing our homies in the community how to do this, how to do that, making little delicious nuggets, doing
snacks.
Also
healthy snacks.
Also unhealthy snacks. We made some good brownies, some good cookies. Cookies with phone tap, I think, was one of my highlights.
Yeah.
And yeah, you know, it's been a trip, and we're actually going to the Hearthstone World Championships in about a month. You ready for that? You ready for that, Tom?
I can't wait.
So that's gonna be pretty good, and yeah, we made a lot of. Whoa, that just went out.
Let's get a little medium action.
There you go.
So in the process too, we did a couple of all cooking shows.
Okay.
And those were a lot of fun.
Killer.
As well.
So are we talking stoner video game cooking jams or what? Are
there's a lot of overlap right there, man. Yeah. There is a lot of overlap.
Just put it out there.
Yeah. Yeah, people like watching people cook.
I
and
feel
people...
like the first episodes were literally like how to chop vegetables.
Cool.
Yeah. Right. And then we had like Mas D on, and it was how to debone a chicken thigh and tie it up with butcher twine.
And make risotto.
Yeah, and make risotto.
Out of your leftovers.
Yeah. Now, am I the old guy because I remember the secret code to Contra?
No.
Up, down, up, down, B-A-B. Yeah. I don't think you're the old guy. I think you're just...
the old guy?
I think you're sliding right in there. Yeah.
All right. I do have that in
I don't.
My wheelhouse.
I wonder if there's...
I like you.
Yeah.
Up, down, left, right.
Yeah. That's a thing, you know. People still remember.
Yeah. I saw that there was an article today about all the articles that came out in the 90s about injuries that kids were having from playing video games too much.
Yeah.
And how now there's this new wave of articles about people having injuries from their iPhones and their iPads.
I remember seeing a couple of years ago, back when I had a flip phone, an article of like Japanese men that would BlackBerry too much. With like the picture was like a Japanese guy with like injury, you know, like... things wrapped around, bandages around his thumbs from typing on his BlackBerry.
Apparently, that's very common now.
What was the first video game you guys played?
The first video game? I probably played, you know, like, you mean after...
Oregon Trail.
I played...
The Oregon Trail, what, in school?
This
Oregon
one.
Oregon Trail, yeah. School.
I played some other weird video games. Yeah, first video game is...
I had to get it in at school.
Yeah. First video game is an interesting one, but first video game that I don't know, it's because I must have played Pac-Man when I was like two or three years old, you know? Do you remember the first one you played?
Pong, to be honest with you.
So Pong is like after, that's definitely before me. I think Pac-Man.
I'm not that old, but I mean, definitely.
But
Pong.
Like, that's like 2 or 3 years. Yeah.
My dad bought it for the house.
The first video game system I owned was a Sega Master System.
Whoa. I had that Sewer Shark game. It was like Sega CD.
No. This is
the first Sega CD.
This is
game.
Before Sega CD. So, the Sega Master System actually had this really cool feature where even if you didn't have a game,
you want to tell the people about that. Even that simple thing.
I'm just smashing some garlic so I can cut it up for the sauce that's going with our chicken thighs.
But you smash it so that it's easy to peel, right?
Yeah, exactly. And then easy to break down.
So Sega Master System.
Yeah.
If you didn't have a game, you could still turn it on, because you know with regular Nintendo, you turn it on without a video game in it, and it's a fucking. It's just going to flash, and everybody's going to get upset. It's hanging around you. But with Sega Master System, if you turned it on, there was a maze game that was built into the motherboard. Gotcha. So you could actually play a game without having a cartridge.
Okay.
And it had the dual cartridge system, where it had a cartridge you could put on top, and it had a weird, like, ID card that you could slide in. You don't remember this?
No, I remember this as well.
Yeah.
I know what he's talking about.
Twitch chat knows what I'm talking about.
Yeah. Oh, sure. That's true. I remember. I got a Nintendo when I was...
18?
25.
16? 25?
Yeah.
25? Really?
Well, because I could finally, you know...
So, do you have a game that you are, like, the best at amongst your peeps?
Well, I think that when I was younger, my go-tos were, and this is definitely aging me, was like Metroid.
Bang it.
Ooh. Metroid, Castlevania, those were my jams.
Yeah,
but when I was older, I used to work for this magazine, and Rockstar was one of my clients. and they would just send me all of their stuff. And the last game that I was genuinely...
So you don't cut the butt off of those? You just go in, huh?
Just go in.
Oh, amazing. I'm never going to cut the butt off again. I'm never going to waste my time.
There you go.
All right.
See, we learn every episode.
Yeah, the last game that I was genuinely involved with was San Andreas.
See, San Andreas, to me, it was too fucking much, man. It was weight, like, you can go to the gym, you can get fat, you can ride a bike, you can drive a car.
Awesome.
Yeah.
You can get tattoos. Get was, weird.
You could definitely get weird.
You could do gang fights. It was awesome.
Yeah.
But that, I mean, that, and this, what's this, like, 2004?
2006.
And like, how, where have things gone since then?
That's
stupid. What's the evolution?
The stupid new game, No Man's Sky. Have you heard about this?
No.
So No Man's Sky was touted as this, the greatest, most expansive game to ever be released, and it's infinite in its possibilities.
Yeah.
And it's turns out it's kind of single player, so you're just roaming around an infinite universe by yourself.
Yeah.
But
it's,
it was.
It's a meditation, though.
Like, I don't know. Sounds like a shitty way to meditate.
It, but it's just like you go walk around this weird digital world.
I think that a lot of people thought was that you were going to be able to hang out with other people and like get on an airplane with another person and go discover a planet.
Right.
Or like you go to a planet and I have no fucking idea. But apparently it sucks, and that's the evolution, is it sucks and people play wizard poker now.
Yeah, Wizard Poker's pretty cool.
All right, so let me ask you a question. How connected is the gaming universe to the comic book universe?
Oh, not connected.
At all.
I don't think so.
There's a couple of games that are based on comic books.
But aren't the people
the
that are...
very vibrant games are their own.
I think
own
that the, it's different. I think that comic books... Artists and artisans are into comic books. And
but the kids that are playing video games, aren't they into comic books?
I think they're into comic book movies. I don't know if, like, dudes...
Aren't they the nerds that are reading...
I was
the nerd that was reading...
I'm getting shaken off.
I think it's separate now, because video games are... So like, this game, Hearthstone,
yeah,
is a game based on another game. Based on the character.
It's based on World of Warcraft.
Gotcha. Lore of another game.
So you need the immersion
on, like,
blender?
Batman.
Are you okay?
The what?
Immersion blender?
Not yet.
Okay.
It's based on another video game. So I think these worlds sit kind of separately.
Really?
That's not to
That's
say.
That's so weird.
I think when you go
Thanks,
to
sir.
A,
yep.
If you go to a video game convention, you'll see people dressed up as characters from video games, not characters from comic books. Right?
Got it.
And if you went to a comic book convention, you'd see
yeah.
people dressed up as characters from comic books. But I don't think the worlds really overlap.
Did you salt this, by the way? Or no?
Game or two.
Just out of curiosity.
I salted the onions earlier with your special white pepper.
The 1090?
1090 jam, which I'm just learning about, which I'm really psyched about.
Yeah, it's good.
But I'm going to hit it again. But I did a whole tomatoes, San Marzano,
okay.
Which I just squeeze in my hands.
Oh, that's how you do it?
Instead of being a weirdo, just because I trust the whole ones versus the cubed ones?
I'll show you what I go in for, is I don't go for the San Marzano. I just go for this.
The box, yeah.
The box.
The pommy.
Yeah.
Totally. My girl's a big fan of that.
It's kind of simpler, and it's like I cut the top off with a pair of scissors, and then I'm done. Yeah.
It's a stupid thing because I'm a gardener and I like the fact that I can.
So did you?
Oh, it's whole.
Did you have a good tomato season? Because tomato. It was a nice hot year. Did you get good tomatoes?
Terrible tomatoes.
Really?
Well,
oh my god! I had so many good tomatoes.
I got nothing. I got nothing. Nothing, and none of my clients had really good tomatoes at all either.
You want to rinse?
No, I'm okay.
Okay. So you missed is the hand squish.
The hand squish into the pan?
No, crushing the tomatoes, crushing the whole tomatoes. Let me give you a rinse here.
It's like a back home.
All right, so you got onions, tomatoes, garlic, anything else?
Garlic, we're gonna go in with some lemon zest.
Okay. What's the lemon zest into the tomato sauce, huh?
Yeah.
And what does that do? Because I've never really done that.
Just brightens it up a bit.
Oh.
Well, I do lemon zest and lemon juice.
Just lemon zest and juice.
Zips it up.
So that's interesting because I would assume, and maybe I'm wrong, that there's the like the double acid, but maybe lemon juice is basic? Or is it not?
It's a different flavor profile.
Different flavor. Okay.
Gene Germs points out that it's pretty funny that we would call comic book people nerds here on our Hearthstone podcast.
I mean that in a good way. I was trying to get people on my team, because I'm a comic book guy and not a video game guy.
That's what we explained.
I'm sorry, dude.
No, that's a very good point. I'm also a comic book nerd. I was telling Sasha that I spent $150 in the comic book store 2 days ago.
Did you really?
I got a random text. He's like, oh yeah, like yada yada yada, having this kind of day, that kind of day. Plus, I spent $150 at the comic book store. I did go to the
comic book store.
Various things. I could talk about.
So I went to the comic book store the same day. The same day I went to the comic book store to buy a comic for a friend of mine who has a 12 or 14 year old son. And he's in Texas, and I was thinking, okay, like,
Little lemon zest. So
what's a good comic for a 12 or 14 year old?
That's nice, by the way. You see that?
The zest into Yeah.
You were in the bathroom. We already did this.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
Yeah, we talked about this.
Cool. Okay.
So Tom, I was thinking, Killing Joke is not age appropriate for 14.
Ooh, no.
Even though I read it at 14. I read it at 12 years old.
It's so good.
It's so good.
And it stuck with you so hard.
Yeah. I remember so many of the scenes, but it's not age appropriate if I was going to send it to somebody. So I went with...
The interesting thing is now that Dark Knight Returns like won't blow a 12-year-old's mind because all the Batman movies for the past 10 years have been based on the Dark Knight Returns.
Hmm.
So you can't like fuck somebody's head up with that.
Right.
You know.
I have a very... It's one of the strongest memories in my life. Is Guns N' Roses, Appetite for Destruction, and the smell of Marvel comic books, and just listening and reading, tearing off some corners.
Yeah.
The smell, and it was predominantly X-Men. All the mutant nerd stuff.
I was into X-Factor.
X-Factor's cool.
I was into Archangel was my favorite all-time super...
Because after he was the Angel, he was great.
He was Archangel. Yeah. He shot crazy things out of his wings.
Were you pissed?
Was...
Did you see the movie?
No.
The movie was bullshit.
I did not see the movie.
Oh, the movie's the fucking worst.
I refused to see any of those movies.
All right, let's nerd out a bit. Until Marvel gets the rights back from Fox...
For X-Men.
All of the mutant titles are going to be dog shit. Yeah. Gonna be complete dog shit.
What a headline! All the mutant titles will be dog shit.
They have the rights to everything. New Mutants, X Force, X Factor.
The first days
everything.
Of
New
Future
Mutants.
Past.
Everything. All, oh
the
my
first
god.
First days of Future Past was dope. I thought.
That's because the rest they set the bar so fucking low.
That's right. Although X Men 2 was okay. Not 1 or 3. But
it was Brett Ratner.
Okay.
Who's a fucking piece of shit.
Yeah, he's a piece of shit. But so is R. Kelly, and his music's great.
Hey, I'm a pee on you. I'm a pee on you, girl.
Drip, drip, drip. All right, back to basics.
Now we're banned.
Okay. All right. So, how's your sauce tasting?
My sauce is getting there. I want to turn it up a bit. Get a little bit more action.
What's the mozzarella for? I forget.
We're going to roll it in the chicken thighs with the prosciutto.
God damn.
So I know
it's about to get live. We're live tonight.
This is literally just like a base.
We talked about your chefing briefly, but when did you really first start like cooking? You know, this is pretty involved. It isn't, you know.
I don't know. I cook. I've always cooked, but
Always cooked like your mom would say, like, Dave, I'm busy. Dave, hook it up. Make the fish sticks.
I'm from South Africa, then Australia, then the States, and so we have big roasts.
If
for
you
holidays.
Cut the globe into thirds, you've hit all three.
I've hit them all, but we did big roasts for a lot of holidays. And when I was 13, I started taking over things, and my first job at 15 was making Caesar salads at a steak and seafood restaurant.
So do you remember the recipe?
I I just made 3,000 of them a night. I just banged it out. My favorite thing about the restaurant was the fact that there was a walk-in cooler where they had all the cocktail sauce.
It wasn't a walk-in cooler with a couple of guys doing blow.
No. It wasn't like that kind of walk-in cooler. It was like a dirtbag 14-year-old with a vat of shrimp and a vat of cocktail sauce.
And you guys just go ham.
And I would just go in there and just go, this is my favorite thing on the planet. Then I started doing soups and O-bar and all sorts of things. But I always
Oyster bar? O-bar?
Yeah. But I always cooked, and then that led to me doing landscape design, because I started nerding out and growing vegetable gardens and starting things by seed indoors in January and doing 40 heirloom varietals.
Do you have a favorite heirloom tomato? Only the hardest hitting questions on Chef only, Sasha.
Yeah. We were talking about the X-Men earlier. Now we're talking about this.
Now everybody gets quiet everybody gets focused and starts thinking about their lives.
It's a striped German.
The striped German?
Which is, it's really kind of the tastiest tomato you've ever tasted in your life. All right, so what's next? What are we going to do?
All right, so you got your sauce.
That's I'm going to let this keep going for a little bit.
So I'm going to drop it down to a lower, less bubbles. Is it okay? A little bit.
Yeah.
All right, so we pounded out the... I think we roll them up.
All right, let's...
Or do we preheat the oven? We have an hour.
Yeah. Okay. We're half an hour in.
Cool. Let's get this done before we do that.
So you want to move it to over here? This is like a simmer. Back there.
I'm gonna do that in here. Where do you have an outlet?
Tom, can you hook this up? Hold that 1 second.
Where's
Are we
next?
Full? Oh, we're over here then.
We can go that way.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
I got it. Want to handle that?
Yeah. So what are we doing?
Can that reach?
Just
whip it up.
Just whip it up. All right.
Yeah.
What's your distance?
Just put it right here.
Can I cheat you this way? A little more?
Yeah.
Actually, give me
oh, we got this thing? Hold on.
Second.
Okay. Oh, this smells really nice, Dave.
I'm going to give you some basil to throw in there.
Okay. Shout out to Francis and the Lights. New album. Oh, this is the new camera angle.
Yeah.
Hey, people.
It's pretty... They call this a Dutch.
This is a Dutch?
This is the windmills. The windmills.
You've heard Greek style.
So when you do this, when the camera angle does that, it's called a Dutch angle. New Dutch angle camera. In honor of Dave on our first cooking episode, season 2.
Yeah. So Dave, you are South African, American, and Australian. Do you have a favorite eating holiday?
Very good question.
It's a very good question, actually. I don't know. I think Christmas would be my favorite in terms of throwback.
Yeah?
Roasts and that sort of thing.
What do you do?
We traditionally do on Christmas Eve, we do a leg of lamb.
Do you go jelly?
Yeah. We do a leg of lamb, and then Boxing Day after Christmas, we do a ham.
So what the hell is Boxing Day? That's like you give your leftovers to homeless people?
I actually, to be honest with you, I have no idea.
That's what I thought. In my mind, I'm thinking, oh, it's the day after. It's Boxing Day. You box up all your leftovers.
Well, you would know better than anyone.
Because you're Canadian. Because
Polish.
You're Canadian.
You're Polish, but you're in that universe.
Wasn't there a tradition happening? No,
Poland and Canada are definitely in different universes.
We just spend 12 days in Poland. We spend 12 days in Christmas. We don't do any boxing.
No homeless people?
There's homeless people, but everybody's...
At home.
I'm going to stop myself. I'm going to get banned from Twitch.
Take it easy on the Twitch.
All right.
Boxing Day, I think, is a unique
How's that look?
English
Keep going?
Holiday.
I think it's Canadian. Pretty goddamn Canadian,
no,
too.
No, I think it's English.
You think it's English?
Yeah.
I think it's Canadian.
Which chat will tell us?
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
Hey, Twitch chat. What's boxing?
Okay, we got a nice sauce. That looks very beautiful, by the way.
That does look very beautiful.
And that goes back in. There's a rubber spatula in there if you want to do a little scraping.
Thank you, sir.
So we're back in this world.
We are back in this world.
We are back in this world.
Back
huh?
in this world. We're not talking about the X-Men anymore.
Yeah, for a few minutes.
All right, so we got our sauce. Sauce is done.
We got our sauce.
Drop it
good
in there.
To go.
Fox really does fuck that.
We're gonna wrap some things up. Would you like to make us a snack?
Yeah, please.
Let's get some oil going.
Cast iron pan,
yeah,
okay?
Yeah, yeah. Use that
this
bad
little
boy.
Guy? Okay.
Use that bad boy. And put that chicken skin in there.
All right, what else? Just chicken skin and oil?
Chicken skin and oil. Then we do it on paper towel, a little salt.
Okay.
Well, chicken skin fritters. Did you get the toothpicks, by the way?
I fucking. If you put toothpicks in a text message, I did not read toothpicks. I do possibly have entirely long skewers.
You could whittle something.
Hold on.
Could you whittle something?
You could whittle something from one of your shelves.
Hold on. Cheesecloth. Ah.
Oh. What? Here we go. That's
beautiful. Who wants to get impaled?
We need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Beautiful.
Okay, you got some extras?
Beautiful thing.
Why would I go to the store and buy toothpicks when I have...
When you can steal them from your job.
You have toothpicks at work?
No. But I imagine...
You a toothpick guy? Oh, this? Don't worry
this
about...
This whole thing?
Don't worry about him.
This whole thing? Do you have scissors anywhere?
Oh, sure.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks, sir.
So I got these scissors at this weird scissors store in Chelsea. They got so many scissors. So many scissors. You wouldn't believe me if I told you.
So many scissors, the best scissors, believe me. Tremendous scissors.
Maybe, tremendous. Maybe, I don't know. The best scissors ever?
People say they're the best scissors. I don't know.
So should we talk a little bit about how this episode was supposed to be make tofu great again?
Well, but then we change that to I'm with tofu.
Oh, I'm with tofu.
Because, one, you know what's interesting, Dave, is about a year ago, we had an episode where
yeah.
we built a deck, like, based on Trump, because it was so funny and ludicrous that Donald Trump would be...
You know what my prediction was, Dave? My prediction was he's going to win Texas, and that's it.
Yeah.
No offense to Texas.
Oh, this is recorded.
A year ago.
I said, he's going to win Texas, and that's
it. It was so simpler then.
Last June.
I was like, oh, you know, Ted Cruz, the genius of them, the genius of the crew is going to... Because Ted Cruz is a fucking smart guy. Ted Cruz, he's a maniac genius.
Yeah.
He's one of the smartest... I think he's like a constitutional PhD kind of guy. But he's crazy. But that's who I had pegged. Shows what I know.
Well, you and...
So what are you doing here? You're just unwrapping them?
Yeah.
Oh. Oh, that looks good. Oh, this is going to be very nice. I think I might take a picture of this, Dave. I don't think I've ever done this. But I'm actually going to take a picture on stream. Look at these beautiful little goddamn chicken things.
Chicken skin chips.
You think they're gonna get crunchy chippy?
Oh no, we're gonna keep on there until they're brown.
Oh. Should we hit them with some salt?
After.
After?
Yeah.
Oh.
All right, we got that. Do we have another prep plate?
Sure.
Just to set things up.
Yeah.
Oh, we need our dredging sitch set up.
Okay, so.
We need another round of cocktails.
We need another round of cocktails. We need dredging. Okay. I was just about to say, I'm so happy that I not have to do anything. All right. So there's your plate. There's a plate. Dredging setup is back.
Is this normally like drunk history, or is it different?
It's pretty much.
All right.
Oh, look, Twitch chat did tell us what Boxing Day is. It's an English holiday where employees receive gifts from their bosses.
Oh, it's like giving to the homeless.
When a boss gives a gift and a box to their workers. Twitch chat, you guys are the greatest.
See? Like fans.
See? Look at that. Look at that. These people. They're the best. The best, I tell you. Maybe they're the greatest ever.
Dave's been celebrating Boxing Day all his life. He had no idea. He's like, it's when you box in Poland.
How do you not know about this?
All right, so what the hell am I doing? I'm setting up the dredge station.
And I need somewhere to put things before getting dredged.
What's a dredge station, Twitch chat?
Okay, so dredging is when you cover something in flour. That's all dredging is.
So what we're going to be doing is we pounded out the chicken thighs, and then we're going to roll them with prosciutto, mozzarella, and some basil.
These look beautiful, by the way, I got to say. These are going to be really fucking
gonna be good.
These are going to be really good.
Super gluttonous, like gross yakitori style.
I've had yakitori, but I feel like I've never had like I've never been to Japan.
Oh. Tomek, tell us about Japan.
It's full of delicious food.
What was the grossest thing you ate there?
The fetus, the chicken fetus. He's like,
what was the second grossest thing you ate there?
That was way too gross, dude.
That was way too gross, dude. You need to take it down a notch, because that was fucking disgusting.
Now, what sex club did you go to?
I think eel's pretty gross. I had some eel.
Oh, eel is delicious. Chicken fetus is way beyond the pale.
Chicken fetus to eel, you pussy.
Everything just else I ate there was...
Come back. Don't be shamed by me.
No, that was it. That was the grossest thing was chicken fetus. The second grossest thing was eel. Which
I'm gonna flip these little fuckers.
Watch those.
Thank you.
Oh, you guys are killing it right now. Dave, your hands must be covered in prosciutto.
We have so many views!
This is what it's all about. It's all about the views.
Holy shit!
All right, so...
Paper towel and some salt.
Okay. You need a third, fourth plate?
No, just whatever you need to put that on.
So, Dave, are you
just do it right here for right now.
Okay. Are they ready to come off or a little bit more?
Yeah. Well, let's see.
Are you a bring your lunch to work kind of guy?
These days I am, because we're trying to save up.
Uh-huh.
We're,
You saving up for something?
We're pregnant.
Like. If your girlfriend is watching, you're in so much trouble, dude.
All right, let's get those the fuck out of here.
Okay.
What's your strategy for the people at home? What are your strategies for lunch?
For getting
lunch
pregnant?
To work?
Honestly, I've been doing a lot of rice, tofu, and kimchi dinners lately.
This smells really
which
nice.
Sounds oh, here, gross.
When you hit it up.
No,
with the salt?
Leave it for a little bit.
Oh, yeah, you let it chill?
We're going to let it cool out.
Flip it over.
Let it do its thing. And then we each get one.
Will
beautiful.
Move it down here?
Yes.
We each get one.
Okay, and I should start on this next round of cocktails.
Amen.
Yes, please.
Okay.
What, should we do something about the hot oil?
I turned it off. I don't know if there's anything else you'd like to do. Any ideas?
Yeah, we'll just put it somewhere else.
You can put it in the tin can if you want.
Let's do a tin can.
Fry up some of that good tomato. All right, what the hell's going on here?
It is the birthplace of post-holiday re-gifting, Boxing Day. I also did assume that it was about boxing. Ooh, it's about
This is why we get...
Flip, flip.
Okay, more cocktails. I'm on it.
Finally.
Okay, the dredging station is set up.
Do everything around
here. Dredging. Tomek, make some cocktails.
It's too late now. Sasha's on it.
All right, I'm on it. Everybody relax.
Oh my god, that's going to be amazing.
Getting lazy. Just do this.
So you make, what you do is you make a dinner for four, and then you have 2 days of leftovers. Is that the move?
That is the move. That's exactly the move.
Yeah.
Okay. How do you handle your dinners and lunches?
Now that I work in the business district of Newark, where there's nothing to eat for a little while. Yeah.
You didn't know he went to Newark?
I had no idea. That was a new jam.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah.
That's terrible. Sorry, Newark. We love you. Love you, Newark.
Station is very nice. What?
That's a joke. Whatever the. I think Texas just shat on you. Yeah. I think just Texas just took you for a ride.
I try to make something easy the night before. But I'm a very new bring your lunch to work guy. Sasha's a veteran.
I'm a vet. All right, Dave, I'm going to give you a couple of options here.
Are you a cook every night, Dave?
I try to be, but we get super lazy.
Okay, so we have some options. I'm going to show them to the people,
especially
and then...
Especially on date night. Please.
So we got the Idris Fiery. It sounds like Rasta, but it's not as Rasta as you want it. This one...
Idris Elba.
Yeah, exactly. The Bundaberg, the Bun-Up.
I've heard
ginger beer.
About the Bundaberg.
Australian family owned.
I'm lying. I've never heard of that in my life. And I don't trust any Australian.
And then
Australian.
We have the non-alcoholic ginger people. They're all now. I don't like the sound. It's got like a teddy bear. It's got a piece of ginger riding a tiger.
That's pretty good.
All right. So.
Riding a tiger, I'm in. Actually, no, that's the. No.
So what do you think? This one's got the funky top and the nice bottle.
I'm going with Idris Fiery.
Okay.
I'm an easy cat.
Let's go with the Idris Fiery. All right. Let's do it to it. Okay.
So how nerdy do we want to get in terms of cooking stuff here?
Nerdy.
All right.
Yeah.
All right, bros. So I'm lining the basil up here. One on top of another.
I think it's bros and broads.
Bros and broads.
Bros and broads.
Which I'm sure you've all seen this before, but... And then you...
Roll it up nice and tight.
Roll it up nice and tight like a cigar.
You like cigars?
No.
I haven't met very many people that actually like cigars. I know people that smoke them.
I think you have to be 60.
I think you all, like, the only cigar that I've enjoyed is when somebody's offered it to me, like, would you like a Macanudo? And it's like a tiny little cigar where you can smoke it for 8 minutes and then you throw it away.
And I believe that's called a chiffonade, but I could be wrong.
It's chiffonade or batonnet.
Or batonnet.
A batonnet is wider, chiffonade is smaller.
Well done.
Fancy pants over here.
I'm just helping you figure it all out.
Oh, thank you, sir.
Okay,
stick so. Stick it in your chiffonade, guys.
That's just for later.
Stick I think. Your batonet in your chiffonade.
I don't know who has.
I had the roundy.
Girl.
I had the roundy.
This is you?
No, this guy.
Oh, this is the strong one. Yeah, sorry. Dave, you got the short end of the stick with the most alcoholic of all the drinks.
Oh, thank you, sir.
You're welcome. Cheers.
Cheers, boys.
Cheers.
Cheers, gents.
And I didn't stir it, so it's going to be.
Cheers.
Who knows what's happening?
Cheers.
Cheers to Gin Germs and Pizza HS.
Oh, that's a little different. That's nice.
It's a different vibe.
Different vibe.
Oh, yeah.
It's a little richer.
Medicine.
Medicine-ier.
I like that.
I like it.
Okay.
It's a tonic.
All right, so we got... Let's get the oven going.
What do you like for time? I mean, for bake.
Like 400?
Well, then you get 400, my man. That's how we do it around here.
I'll take it.
So you got a chiffonade... Of basil, you got some chopped up mozzarella. I didn't mean to do that. Sorry.
Mozzarella, hey, oh, you want the mozzarella?
From New York, it's okay.
I feel like we might have gone a little...
Too thin? Or not thin enough?
No. Too little. But it's just the three of us. It's cool.
Yeah.
But we have our chicken fat, our chicken skin deliciousness.
We do. All right. So we're going to go on top of this with...
Oh, my God.
This is very exciting. I am very excited.
Yeah.
Some delicious prosciutto.
Holy shit.
Oh, yeah. This is kind of fucking wild. I'm not going to lie. This is wild.
Guys, honestly, this might not work. So we're just rolling with it.
I'm sure it's going to work great. This is next level. Well, Dave, you are upping the game for our all-cooking shows.
Yeah, really.
Oh, wait until you see the starter.
I tell you that with no kind of...
Oh, right, and we have a starter, too?
Yeah.
Woo! I didn't bring any fireworks, I'm sorry.
Oh, my God, I brought Roman candles. It's cool.
They're illegal in New York.
Totally cool, guys.
Roman candles are illegal, right?
I don't know.
I don't think so.
Honestly, this might not work, so we're just going to keep going.
Yep, you sound like a chef.
You sound like you want it to work, though.
Oh, I do. I've never done this before.
Well, that's amazing.
We'll see what happens.
All right, so you got...
Wait, so people text in and tell us who thinks Suicide Squad sucked.
Oh.
I didn't see that either.
I didn't see that.
See, good for you, Dave, for going to see these things.
I haven't seen it yet either. I wanted to.
Oh.
I'm not allowed to see it.
What do you mean you're not allowed
I'm
to see
I'm bringing it back to the comic books, because I'm not a DC guy.
Yeah, Tomic's a DC guy. I bet Tomic has read so many Swamp Things.
I've read some Swamp Things.
I'm a Marvel cat through and through. And
DC, I like Vertigo.
I was like the soft shit.
I like Vertigo. I like the whole Vertigo catalog. They did a lot of great things in the 90s.
Yeah.
So you like press, it, huh?
Dark Horse.
Reading Valiant too in your spare time.
You brought up Killing Time.
Valiant
before.
Was like a soft Marvel.
Yeah, Valiant.
Marvel,
Man, Comico. Adam. Comico.
Comico. They had. They
Who's that?
Grendel.
Oh,
Grendel.
Grendel comics. Oof. That was hardcore.
Grendel was. Hardcore.
I remember when. What was it? Marvel lost all of their people to.
Image,
yeah.
Yeah.
Jim Lee left. Jim Lee left. Mark Silvestri, all those guys.
Yeah.
Those are such amazing covers
and
that
you
they
guys
were,
thought I could nerd out.
But nobody questioned your nerd balls, dude. Everybody knew you were gonna come here swinging them. All right, so
Rob Liefeld and Mark Silvestri.
So you got the prosciutto, the chicken.
Silvestri was a budget Jim Lee.
The mozzarella, the basil.
Fuck out of here. Silvestri was the best.
Did you salt them at all?
No, nothing. Nope. We're leaving it alone because the salt's coming from the prosciutto.
Okay.
So we got the cheese, we got basil, we got the chicken. We're good to go.
Okay.
This is where this could go south, guys. Really quickly.
Should we zoom in?
Nah. So we're trying to do...
This is sexy.
We're trying to do...
Do you need your skewer, or do you have it?
No, we're doing skewers.
Oh, look at that. Holy shit. Ah!
Yeah, that's boss.
And we're going to cut these with scissors after we put them through. And then we dredge
stuff. Oh my God. This is something else.
Can you...
Can you make him dance?
Will you show that without compromising this? Yeah, people need to see that. Thank you, Sean Carter.
Oh, so hot!
Was that hot? What's going on?
I was going to, like, you do some contrast.
Oh my God, speaking of hot, can we eat those chicken fucking things?
Oh, yeah. Oh my God, they're totally crunchy chicken thighs.
All right, hold on. Now let's hit them with some of your good stuff.
All right, just round of applause.
Round of applause for chicken skin chips.
This is all working
out. Oh, here, you take the good one.
I'll take this one.
Cheers.
Cheers. Cheers, bros. Oh, yeah.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Mm. Oh, fuck yeah. That's like a fried chicken, except
really
no
bad for you.
No bullshit.
Oh, that was really good.
Dave, I'm going to put that into my repertoire 100%. There is nothing stopping me from frying every chicken skin I encounter from now on.
It's so good.
And you don't really need to do anything besides... Whoa, Tom getting a little... getting right a little trigger happy.
It's right there. Face is the place. Chicken, little chicken in my face. You'd like this game, Dave. Sometime when we're not making a 7-course meal, we'll show you how to play.
It sounds good to me.
Yeah.
I'm just a little old, you know?
No.
I'm a little old.
You're never too old.
All right, so what's next, D?
We got to get that going.
With the peanut oil?
Yeah.
I have peanut oil.
Or whatever we got. The veggie oil is fine.
No, I bought peanut oil because I was very low on... Where? Oh, I think it's in here.
And then I'm going to snip these. We're going to do a hard dredge.
What's the difference between a hard dredge and a soft dredge?
I mean, just get these things because they're totally too thick, so it's a pain in the ass.
All right, so...
It's super loosey-goosey.
Like this much?
Yeah, it should be fine. Oh, we're gonna do a quick like one minute sear in the oil and then in the oven.
One minute.
Get it golden and then let it cool out.
Okay, cool. We're not preheated yet, so
yeah. We got time.
Let me just hit Twitch chat, see what the people are saying.
Fry first.
Oh,
same snap. I gotta clip them. And then we'll dredge them.
Ba-ba-ba-ba. There.
And then the oven. 10 minutes. And then we're good.
All right. This is going very.
How are you looking over here?
We gotta get this set up, right?
So let's do a thing.
All right.
Well, before we do that, gentlemen, who wants to eat more prosciutto?
I'll take one slice, please.
Who doesn't?
Eat
delicious
prosciutto.
Cheers.
Thank you.
Sing.
Okay. We got that done. All right, so, Tom, how's the camera angle?
Do whatever you need to do and I'll adjust.
So, D, we're going to do flour first for the dredge.
Mm-hmm.
You're going to cut them on here. Is that how it's going to go down?
No, after.
So?
No. We dredge them. Dredge them, egg wash, panko, in the oil.
That's it?
Yeah.
Okay.
And then we sear them, and then we put them in the oven.
So do we want to... Here's what I think we're going to do.
We need a landing.
We need a landing. So we're going to dredge... Egg, panko. Okay.
Oh, yeah.
So do you...
And I was going to do some parsley.
You want to season? Okay, perfect.
If you want to roll with that, we can do that.
All right. I got that. You know, I actually have some... Let's see. So you know what I made the other day, Dave?
What's that?
Fried avocado.
I've heard of these things. How'd it work out?
That's a little ass, so I'm gonna get rid of this. It was really good. Yeah. I did fried avocado tacos.
I literally was at a restaurant 2 days ago and they were saying that was a thing and I was like, bullshit.
So you slice the avocado, same thing.
Do you chill it or no?
No, you room temp, you dredge, egg, panko, and I did like finely chopped cilantro in with the panko, awesome. The same way we're about to do. So that's what I did.
Amazing.
And it's very, very nice.
Holy shit! And how did the avocado hold up?
It holds up better than chicken because it's not loosey goosey. It's like a stiff member.
Shit, really?
That's what she said.
Yeah, very good. Very good.
I'm finger in your
very
ear right
good.
Now.
I was wondering who that right was. Now? I'm just trying to. Here? I'm just trying to keep the crowd. You know. Stimulated on all levels.
You think this is good?
Yeah. Okay. I got it.
Oh, I'm in a bad spot here, though.
All right. So, do you have a garden at home, Dave?
I have a garden at my mother's house in Connecticut.
I forgot to turn this on.
You know, we're very fancy.
Well, it depends on what part of Connecticut, brother.
Yeah, exactly.
you could be very unfancy in Connecticut.
In Bridgeport, so take it easy, knuckleheads. But no, I do. I have a garden over there, which I look after with.
And you go up to collect herbs and the like?
When I can, but this summer was pretty brutal. I don't know anyone that actually had a good summer.
My friend works on a farm up in Cold Spring, and they had a great summer for tomatoes. Really beautiful.
Yeah.
Yeah. Giant exploding fucking tomatoes. And a zucchini like you wouldn't believe. The size of my fucking forearm.
Holy shit, zucchinis? We're doing a thing tonight with zucchinis. That's so weird.
I didn't save any, so we have some regular...
That's so fucking weird.
Normal size zucchinis. Not the size of my forearm, but they were massive.
That's a weird, yeah.
These zucchinis were like a baby's arm holding an apple.
Huge zucchinis.
They were huge. You have no idea.
Monstrous zucchinis.
People tell me, but you know, I don't know. Maybe. Maybe they were huge.
Maybe one day. Alright, so we gotta do this stuff.
This is gonna be, I think, one of the most involved things that Twitch chat, or rather Twitch, has seen cooked on TV.
Amen, brother.
What do you got, Twitched?
So you fry them whole. I thought you were going to cut them in half. Oh, shit.
I don't know. We're going whole. As best as we can with...
So there's some tongs somewhere. You get access to the tongs earlier?
Tongs where?
Did we lose it?
Oh no, we're just looking to keep them.
Oh, they're right there.
We're just trying to keep them together.
So you're gonna drop them in one at a time, and you're gonna brown them on one side, then flip them.
Yep.
And then, do you take the toothpicks out?
Not until the end.
Is so interesting. All right, we are fucking, we're balls deep right now.
Well, we're doing it.
That's right.
We're doing some stuff.
Chicken balls.
Chicken fetuses.
We're doing some stuff.
We're chicken fetuses.
Yeah, you had to make it gross. Why'd you make it gross? You had to make it fucking gross.
So you ate chicken fetus sushi?
I ate, it was like, yeah, what's it called? Yakiniku, like the street food.
All right, so we're gonna get some dredging action going.
All right,
here.
So we gotta crack these eggs, right?
We gotta crack these eggs. You're in charge.
All right, Tom, how's the angle? I'll give you time to set it up.
We're good. You get busy.
It looks like you're still working.
No.
Are you playing games?
Okay, now we're
playing
good.
Video games.
No.
So, Dave, you have a one-hand egg technique?
Smash it.
Okay.
I'm deathly afraid of eggs.
so his chicken his chicken fetus thing really cut to the core of your
gross.
Soul.
It made me feel weird. I kind of hate his guts right now.
You could imagine.
It wouldn't be the first time.
How
actually,
I hate my guts.
I have met this man before.
All right, so we beat up the chicken egg. You want me to salt it or anything like that or no?
Nah, just whip it up. Should we do some water, or I think we're okay with loose.
No, I think.
Do it loose. We do flour, egg, panko, boom. We got that rolling.
You got it.
Come here, girl.
That's that chicken fetus.
Come here, girl.
It's got you all worried. So it's got you all worried and nervous puffing your chest up.
Yeah. All right, so I'm gonna hand it. This is gonna be your department.
We're dredging.
You're in charge of dredging and I will hand you paper towels the second you're done.
That term is a little confusing, dredging, because dredging it means like digging up rather than covering in something, right?
Well, I think
it just is what it is.
I don't know.
Heavy dredge. It's good.
Like when you dredge a river,
I get the sides hard.
When you dredge a river, you're pulling up sediment from the bottom.
And we're pulling up sediment, and we're putting it onto the chicken.
All right. I don't know if you viewers know, but Tomek recently bought a plot of land upstate, and his brain just can't seem to get around dealing with different facets of rivers.
He went full Trump supporter moron on us.
he's just up there.
That's right. I own property there. Listen, upstate New York, I own a lot of property.
They're huge. And we do a lot of things there.
Okay. How's that look?
You're good.
So you want me to egg it and then panko?
Egg it and then panko.
You drop it there. Okay, and we're flipping it over. This is very nice, Dave. I'm very happy to be doing this with you.
Seems hard to work.
I wish I could deep fry my fingers now that they're coated in egg and flour and breadcrumbs. And the last one.
Oh, this is possibly the best show we've ever done.
Okay.
Flip.
Oh, it's a piece of flour covered in, a piece of mozzarella covered in flour.
So we got about 25 minutes. You think that's good, Dean?
Oh, that's good.
25?
So we're done?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah. I know, time flies.
That's crazy. We'll get there. Yeah. All right, you keep doing that.
We can go long if we need to.
Actually, we can't. FCC rules.
Oh, those dirtbags.
They just texted me.
No, we got this. We're good. It's a good thing we don't have to toast the pine nuts.
Well, we can toast the slivered almonds.
Hashtag feels bad.
Hashtag fail.
Feels bad, man. Feels bad, man.
Oh. Produce this.
Make tofu great again.
Okay.
Well, I think we probably should have stuck with the tofu nuggets.
I'm with tofu.
I really like I'm with tofu.
Yeah. That's right, goddammit.
Because I think it really plays to everything that all of the Trump supporters really hate about people not eating meat.
That's right.
All right, so we have some nice warm oil. We have some nice things. Not quite yet. All right, so let's move it over. Okay.
So what's going on, guys? We lost your attention?
No, they're still there.
Oh, our people? No, man. It's stronger than ever. Mm. There's even mystery people who are on now who don't have Twitch handles, which means it's probably your relatives or...
No, none of my relatives are involved.
My relatives.
So we're about to deep fry the chicken. And we're actually about to start discussing the new season for the New York Knicks.
Hey.
Which has absolutely nothing to do with video games or cooking, but we're just going to talk some shit really quickly.
Oh, you can put it right in the thing. You're the thing that I get.
Oh, I got a thing over here, yeah. What are you guys thinking?
I think there's two things to remember. Here's what I think. I think we're playoff bound. However, one has to remember that until James Dolan kicks the bucket,
All right, let's start a new season without talking shit about Jimmy Dolan. Can we avoid James Dolan? I'm not a perennial...
Look, I love the Knicks, but I'm not a freak Knicks fan. I remember 1994 when the Rangers won, and I saw a guy with a sign that said, I'm 90 years old, and the Rangers finally won.
Yeah.
I don't want to be that guy, but I think that unless the Second Amendment people maybe do something about this James Dolan guy, then we suffer.
Here's what might happen.
What do you got?
A few of our starters are not going to make it out of the preseason. Derrick Rose might go to jail.
Brandon, oh my God! Brandon, you guys are the fucking worst.
I didn't say anything.
Brandon Jennings may get injured, although I hope not.
You're literally the rest of America talking shit about the Knicks. Instead of being a fucking delusional Knicks fan, we have the best team we've had in forever.
Listen, here's the real good news.
Courtney Lee's better than what? Sprewell?
Courtney Lee is different than David Lee.
You can't compare him to Sprewell.
No, he's the second coming.
I hope so.
Don't cut your hand off, Dave.
I'm good. Oof. He's got me upset.
That was such a nervous last cut, dude.
I love new Mello. I love Dad Mello.
Dad Mello, of course. All right, Seth Rosenthal, if you're watching, blah, blah, blah. He's a big fan of yours.
I love Dad Mello.
Yeah.
And I think we're going to do great. I think, you know, I think we're going to do great. I'm going to watch 70 games this year. That's 70 times 3... That's 200,000. And if they make it to the playoffs, that'll be another 30,000 of basketball.
So you're predicting 78 wins?
Yeah, I am predicting 78 wins.
Oh, I think we're a super team, 100%. Done. Super team. Super team, we're in. We got it. Done.
Woo! Should we start over?
Super team.
Start over.
Super team.
No, seriously, let's. I'm sorry.
We're gonna be good.
We are gonna be good.
We're gonna be really good.
Yeah. We have the best player in the NBA.
No, we don't. Porzingis.
And let
Reggie Miller burn in hell. Yes, absolutely. But I think.
Is that what you say anytime you say something good about a Knicks player? Yes. Let Reggie Miller burn in hell.
Yes. Yes, the Porzingod video got good to me. Hard. But I think we're going to do all right, man. But we're all disillusioned Knicks fans, and we're all idiots.
Yeah.
And we have no concept of reality.
We have a friend, Justin, who every year predicts that the Knicks are going to win the championship. I'm a different breed where I want to set the bar. I'm always going to watch, I'm always going to support, I'm always going to go to a couple of games.
The weird thing is I feel like LeBron is in the finals every single year.
Yeah, but he's the best basketball player on the planet.
And he's in the East Coast.
Yeah.
And we will not really be in the finals.
Dude, if we could play him in the Eastern Conference Finals, that would be a victory. If the Knicks could get to the Eastern Conference Finals, which they might. That would be fucking amazing.
Yeah, but we're going to play him in the first game of the season, and we're going to get our asses handed to us.
Yeah, you never know. Kristaps might just fucking...
You think Kristaps is going to put on 75 pounds?
Yeah, why is your juice on Kristaps? Like, I don't understand that.
He made
a lot of solid moves.
Yeah.
I'm a little bummed out about you in terms of your fandom.
How many times do we get a great player slightly not right who didn't make
it? I think the oil's ready.
Yeah.
I think... I hear you, but we're not talking about Antonio McDyess and like Stephon Marbury. We're not talking about these guys. We're not talking about like Penny Hardaway or
Stevie Francis or Tracy McGrady.
No!
When he made his first three-pointer for us, me and my boy Keith were like, yes!
Yo, I remember an
I remember an ESPN article about Tracy McGrady that was the loneliest man in basketball. And it was just him on a duvet in a mansion, pretty much on the brink of tears because he had no friends because he was the saddest, sleepiest guy in basketball.
I like Tracy McGrady.
What the fuck?
Fuck Tracy McGrady! What no one gives a shit about Tracy McGrady! We're just so pitiful that that piece of shit came to New York.
Right, but
at
that
point in time,
that wasn't, that was Dolan's, that was the, look.
Dolan's the fucking, all right, let's get, let's do timers before we fuck this whole thing up.
Okay, okay, what do you want?
Like a minute aside.
I'm going to give you, all right, I'll give you a minute now, starting now.
Starting now, go, starting? Talk about Tracy McGrady.
Okay, there it goes. No, that's the thing. You know how you have that J.R. Smith for Life shirt?
Yeah, which you gave me.
Before that, we made Fire Scott Layden shirts. And it's all part of the same thing. It wasn't fucking Scott Layden's fault. It's Dolan's fault. That's yes. All I'm saying is that there is this
but
one...
But we got good shit going for the first time
I think
ever.
It's great. No,
why are you not positive?
Every year is good, man.
No, we're assholes
every
year.
The last 3 or 4 years
like,
have been
good. So, the last 3 years have been bullshit.
No, we made it to the
We go to the playoffs.
In 2012.
The Knicks actually go to the playoffs.
Right? We did.
That was the last year.
Then there
that was the best.
Smith was around.
That was the best.
You know, then Shumpert. I was always very excited about Shumpert.
Yo, what I'm excited about is I'm excited about fucking J.R. Smith coming back to smoke a blunt on 145th and send a tweet out to everybody to come and meet him.
That's true. He was good with that.
Okay.
I think this year we're going to win more games than we've won since 2012. I think we're gonna make it to the playoffs as like the fifth, five seed maybe. So, as much as I did a bad job showing it.
These look beautiful,
excited.
By the way. Very fucking beautiful.
We'll get there, we'll see if it, I just wanted to.
They look beautiful.
I wanted to do it before I got, it was just, you cook. You can smell it.
It smells right. The oil smelled like it was ready to go.
Yeah.
This was good. Relax. Talk about basketball. I'm going to give you another
Please
minute.
Give me a minute.
I'll give you a minute.
So we agree.
We agree on everything. Except the fact that you are...
You want Antonio McDice to come back?
No. You are not following suit in the fact that you should be a disillusioned Knicks fan... And aggressively optimistic.
I am
about this
optimistic.
Season.
That's my version of aggressively optimistic.
We're looking good, man.
Derrick Rose is not going to play a single game for us. And that's...
You think he's going to be in jail?
It's pretty much true. Yeah.
He's going to jail?
And then Noah's going to be
Is he involved in Bridgegate?
No, he's...
Oh my god, if Chris Christie was our center...
Let's not ruin our show talking about what he's involved in. That was short-sighted. But besides that, it's fucking... Dude, Courtney Lee, I'm so excited. Brandon Jennings, I'm so hyped, dude.
Courtney Lee is going to be amazing.
Cannot wait, man. Fucking Willie...
That was your minute. You want one more minute?
I'll
give you one more minute.
Hernan Gomez is going to be the man.
I don't
and he
know
took
if I'm
Anthony
that
Mason's
site.
Number. That's going to be awesome. Of a bunch of tall, skinny Europeans. Destroying.
These are going to be so fucking delicious.
Yeah.
This weird
this
fried
insane.
Chicken maniac shit.
It's going to be all right. Oh, is the camera still on? What's up, guys? What's happening? Sorry, we were talking about the Knicks. My bad.
So how did you stay a Knicks fan? And more importantly, how did you become a Knicks fan?
The neck of the woods.
Oh, Australia?
Yeah, Australia.
South Africa?
Absolutely. Well played.
The
well
neck
played.
Of the woods.
Well played. All right. Well played. I went to university in Massachusetts, and at the time was I appreciated basketball, and I was into it, but I was more into...
That's your
I,
second minute.
Let's get that frying pan out. Oh, we're good here?
Yeah.
I was more into the Yankees,
And I went to university in Worcester, Massachusetts.
Worcester?
Where they promptly fucked with me so hard about everything that I, like, a lot of things that I didn't really care about.
You want time?
Like 10 minutes. That's, a lot of things that I didn't even care about. And I kind of decided then and there to, all right.
Set your teeth.
You want to talk shit?
Fuck you.
I'll put
fuck
on a you, Tino fuck. Martinez jersey and I'll sit.
A Tino
sit,
Martinez jersey.
And I'll sit at the bar in Worcester, Mass. And talk shit.
We got to shout out Springfield College, where basketball began.
Is that right?
Apparently.
Yeah.
Side note, we're going to start our starter.
You start the starter?
Yeah. We're going to start our starter.
Dave,
do we have
we got,
a,
we got about
two
10
plates?
Minutes on the show.
10 that minutes? Sound, oh, Jesus Christ. Better. We're not going
to
eat
we
anything.
Need to stretch. We get, not on stream. But if we finish the dish.
All right, we can fake finish the dish.
Tomek is your girlfriend producer right now.
Yes, I know. And she's
okay.
Secretly watching.
So you have two plates.
Just give me them right here.
You want separate or
yeah,
on top
yeah,
of each other?
Fine.
She could be watching if she downloads.
All right, so we got no pine nuts.
We have... Fake,
it's okay.
We have fake pine nuts. You want me to toast these up real quick, one time?
If you can, yeah.
You got it, baby.
Give me some fake toasting action.
This is gonna be real toasting action on fake pine nuts. I fucked up, and I thought that I had pine nuts, and yet
you didn't fuck up.
They're not pine nuts.
It's
they're slivered almonds.
It's a happy accident.
And we're gonna
all good, dude.
The thing is when we're toasting them in fried chicken skin fat, we're doing fine.
It'll be solid.
I think that you won't know the difference between almonds toasted in fried chicken fat and pine nuts toasted in olive oil.
Oh, that's a lot right there. You can't repeat that, can you, right now?
I think you won't know the difference between almonds toasted in chicken fat and pine nuts toasted in olive oil.
Oh.
Woo!
The most diverse and intelligent show.
Do you guys see people dabbing?
Did you just dab on them?
I dabbed on them.
You just dabbed on them?
I dab on people once in a while. Once in a blue moon, you gotta dab on them. Just to make sure that everybody's paying attention.
Oh my God.
The appetizer, what's going on?
So the appetizer is a delicious thing that I had in Florence.
I see this.
At a place called Buca Mario, which is raw
Mario's
zucchini.
Mario's mouth.
A little raw zucchini. White truffle oil,
oh, really?
Toasted pine nut, and shaved Parmesan.
Oh, Parmesan, coming up.
Oh, yes.
So I had a little, like, nugget, but I decided to opt out of the nugget, and we got a full chunk.
Oh, you're not fucking around, all right.
No, let's get, like, nice, big, thick, fat chunks on this. Yes, Dave.
You need butter over there.
You want butter? I can do butter.
A little butter on that.
Butter I can do. Whoa.
This is using every available space.
Okay, butter. You know, I actually went to a Parmesan factory, and the guys made fun of me because I didn't know how to do the stuff. Long story short...
I don't understand what you just said.
Long story short, I went to a Parmesan cheese place where they made Parmesan cheese, and the guy was like, oh, do you want to make, you know, help us, like, pop the Parmesan cheese out? And he said, you bang it down, and then you pop it up. And I thought, oh, you just bang this giant paddle down into... 50-gallon Milkway thing.
Yeah.
I got this story's going nowhere.
No, you're killing it. Keep talking.
That was horrible. I'm tapping out. I'm done. I'm going to keep moving these fake pine nuts.
We're doing a little fake pine nut.
It's like a California roll.
It's going to be phenomenal. It's going to be huge.
Pine nuts. Pine nuts are huge.
You can
Dave, is there anything else in this kitchen right now that you want to fry? Because we really haven't. We've got it.
No, let's fry some stuff.
So let's fry up these.
We got mozzarella. Let's fry some stuff.
Let's fry this zucchini shit.
Here, brother. Put that in the thing.
Let's put that in the thing. Let's cook this back. Wait. Oh, you're heating the sauce up. Okay. We'll do that. Straight out of the garbage. This is like George Costanza eating the eclair out of the garbage.
Yeah, I won't bite out of it. So, but the Knicks.
Oh, you two were right there with a George Costanza eclair reference.
Everybody knows.
That's
about
interesting. I actually don't know that.
Where you were?
No, I don't know that reference.
With your Yankee hat on, like.
Yeah.
Talking about Seinfeld.
I'm the dirtbag with the Detroit Tigers hat on.
Following the Knicks. But how did you stick with the Knicks? Because you know, basketball. They don't care as much about basketball up there. Football and baseball, that's...
Up there? Where's up there?
Where you went to school.
Well, no, I went to... I'm from Connecticut, New York.
Yeah.
But oh, you are?
In Massachusetts.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
The basketball, like, wasn't a fight to pick.
Oh, it was at that point. 96?
Yeah, that's true.
96, 97, 98, 99?
But the Celtics were nothing then.
No, they were dog shit. Yeah. So it was great.
Yeah.
And the Yanks were destroying the Sox.
Yeah.
It was beautiful, but I was always a Knicks fan.
Yeah.
And I moved to Australia to go work for this magazine, came back and realized I actually desperately missed basketball.
Yeah.
Did you play basketball, Dave?
Yeah, a little bit.
What do you play?
Not well.
What's your position?
I play bench.
I play the bench.
I play bench.
I play the bench and I play the embarrassed guy. That's the seven.
Yeah, I'm like 16. I'm 16. He sort of made the team, but didn't really.
Well, I was in a church league in elementary school in Atlanta for 2 years.
That's the nine. That's the white guy that gets yelled at.
I was a bench warmer, and I almost made a basket once. And I still remember that basket that I almost made.
Oh, zucchini fritters.
And how much I almost made it.
What you got?
I have exactly the same thing that you did everything else with.
Zucchini fritters.
I gotta say, when we're frying shit, everything's gonna go right.
Hey, you put butter in here, right?
I put butter in here.
Beautiful.
Just for you.
Thanks, sir.
So we're at 2 minutes until it comes out of the oven.
We'll let it chill out.
Yep. Oh, is this a giant chunk of Parmesan?
So we're at 2 minutes before the end of the show, but we've gone long before and we can go long. Thank you. We should.
Do we need to plate some stuff?
No, we need to
fake some stuff.
So. Yeah, plate it, fake it.
Let's do some plate and faking.
Wow, that Parmesan.
Good Parmesan. It might be a little warm.
But we don't have to fake it. Do we need another 10 minutes on this? Don't take it out before it's ready. Whoa.
That's legit. Oh, you want to show the camera? Do it, Dave.
What's up, camera?
Hey, yo.
What happened?
Smoke. He's just overwhelmed by the emotion.
I know. It's so
yeah,
heavy.
That was not smoke. That was so heavy. That wasn't smoke, bro. That was emotion.
So serious. You guys are just, it got so good to me. All right, I know this one is 100% done.
Yeah, that one looks beautiful. Okay, so you take the toothpicks out. It's part of the tradition.
The whole jam.
Wait, Dave, I'd like to take some, do a little sexy video. Is that
sexy
okay?
Sexy video.
Oh, God.
Oh.
Oh, God. Steamy. Steamy, creamy.
That is... Why you keep touching it again, I have no idea, but If you didn't, right, so if you didn't burn yourself in a way that upset you, I'm blown away.
We're gonna do a little. We got some spoons. I got spoons.
I need a little flipperino.
I got some.
Oh, you're just fucking freaking out right now, man.
Oh, so melty, so cheesy. Yo, this one goes out to pizza. Yeah. This is how it goes down. Well, hot damn.
Are we a little of the palm? Are we out? Are we out already?
No, yeah, we're not.
Yeah, we can be out. Just show the dish. Make our shout outs. Oh.
That looks beautiful.
Dude.
Totally fucking beautiful.
You're freaking out.
Oh, wait. No, we're not done yet. I'm going to turn the heat off here. We have to finish the primer or the appetizer. You got it? Those are toasty. What is this goodness? Oh.
Damn.
Yeah.
Oh, those are going to be bananas.
Good. Those look pretty good.
Just chuck them in there.
I'm going to let them marinate on this paper towel for a second. Think about what they've done. Got a little quiet here. Everybody's
very solemn, but got very intense.
All right, so Tom, you have the prep station?
Yeah.
Volume 2?
Yeah.
Dave, I hope you've had fun.
I've had the best time ever.
This is the best time ever?
Yeah, no, this is, well, it's not the best time ever, but, you know, it's been a good time.
Well, when the camera goes off, I'm going to hook you up. We'll do the best time ever.
No, don't do this. This has been great.
See, I don't ever hit the palm with the peeler. And that's going to change the whole game. This is going to change my whole cooking game, is the parm with the peeler.
And the garlic, not cutting off the ends of the garlic.
Also going to change the game.
Frap!
Right there.
All right, where's my white truffle oil?
No idea. I have no idea where your white truffle oil is. Well... It's around here somewhere, right?
Did you bring it with you?
No, I brought it. It's on the
table. Oh, there it is. There. Hey.
No, but I want. We're gonna skip the.
Oh, a little dab will do you. That is beautiful. Oh my God! Here we go.
We're gonna skip the almonds. Taste that while the cameras are on.
We're skipping the almonds?
Yeah.
Okay.
Taste it while the camera's on.
You want a fork? You want to class it up?
Yeah. What kind of an operation are we running here?
Yeah, really. Well, the kind of operation where you eat a fork right off the floor.
Fourth floor.
Just jump in. Little knife action?
I don't know.
Oh, we can do all of the things over here. Do we have a camera over here?
We do.
Yeah, wait, it's right here.
Oh, boom.
Oh, so close. So did they cut it for you?
No.
No.
I'm just being a weirdo right now, trying to make you.
Ooh, I'm totally in the frame. All right.
It's very beautiful.
You can be in the frame.
Everyone say something nice. We're about to
that is beautiful.
We're about to take you out. Dave, shout outs.
Are we out?
Shout outs, yeah.
So, Dave, I have to say, You wouldn't know this, but I don't like truffles. This is the first time I've enjoyed truffles. Truffle oil, first time.
I'll take that.
I usually hate truffles. That's why I was like, hey, dude, I don't have fucking truffle oil. Bring your own fucking truffle oil. I don't want to go and spend $15, $20. I have no idea how much truffle oil costs.
All right.
But this is totally fucking delicious. I'm going to go in for another bite.
I'll take that.
And then I'm going to go in for
a shout out. Eat some food.
I will. Dave, anyone you want to...
yeah, Dave, do a shout out.
Hi, guys.
Your pregnant fiance?
Kat, good luck in the next 3 months. We're going to get there, babe. Stop yelling at me.
And on that note, thank you all so much for tuning in. Shout out to my peeps in Texas, my peeps in Queens, everywhere, globally, international peoples. Thank you so much for tuning in, and we'll be back in 2 weeks with some awesome guests, and we're going to do some Hearthstone action, and we'll see you next time.
Yeah, and thanks to Dave.
Dave!
First cooking guest of season 2.
Good job, guys!
Hey.
The number one club promoter right now.
We'll talk more about video games.